Jason Rona here. We're doing a pro pit tip here with Steven Hartson in Red RC. Steven is one of the nation's finest indoor racers in 1/10 scale off-road buggy racing. And Steven's got the Team Associated B4.1 WC car. Steven, tell us a little bit about when you're racing indoors. You do a lot of OCRC, West Coast. You're traveling all over the place on these indoor national series races that we're doing, and you've been successful everywhere you've been. Tell us how you equip your car and why you do some of the things that you do.
One of the main things indoor racing is getting your tires right, having the right inserts, sauce too is a major thing. Basically just finding the right setup for your car for the indoor stuff. I know the outdoor stuff is a little different with the setup, mainly tires too, but mainly just getting your tire setup right is really big.
Okay. If an OCRC West Coast tracks you race in California, the gold compound is typically what you run there, correct? You do some tire break-in. Tell us to what extent do you break in your tires when you race out there? And I know you bring a little grinder with you, one of the things that they use in the touring car racing world, and sometimes you do some prep. Tell us why you do that, and how much time it takes you to kind of get your set where you like them before you race out there.
Yeah, like you said, I have a little grinder, and basically just to break in the tires to a point where they start working, which is normally about halfway down. Just trying to get a scuff on the tire is the big thing. It just seems to help a lot.
We've been working with Steven for quite a while with JConcepts. We developed this Bro Code tire that's recently going to be released here. We've debuted some of it here this weekend, and it was a lot of with Steven's testing. He knows about breaking in tires. That's part of the Bro Codes, is a lower tread, more broken in, something that Steven has been working on for quite a while. And that kind of covers our tire package here. With the inserts, that's another big factor. And you talked about some tire traction and tire sauces, which you're kind of known for a little bit, but it's something that's been around a while. Tell us on your insert selection what you like to do front to rear, and when you run closed cell as opposed to open cell.
Definitely in the rear I run closed cell. The dash 2 JConcept stuff is really good. The fronts, I usually run stock foam, usually cut down rears to about 3/4 of the full size. Mm-hmm. That's usually what I always run.
Okay. Well, that helps out a lot. Get your wheel and tire combination set up. Now, going into the setup here, you've been running the big bore shocks for quite a while as the prototypes with the Team Associated. They've just released them as the brand new option part, factory team big bore shocks. What's your setup? What do you run indoors? What do you run in California? And what are you running here?
Basically, we found that the two-hole pistons are work really well. The 1.6 by 2. I usually always run 30 weight in the back, 32.5 in the front. The new Associated springs I just got, they're really good. I have greens in the fronts, whites in the back. Outdoors I might go up in oil a little bit, but other than that it's a pretty standard setup.
Okay, and you're at the inside hole in the rear arm as pretty usual, inside on the tower, you're outside on the front arm, inside on the front tower, that's pretty standard for you, right?
Yep.
Okay, and moving on to your power selection, I notice you got the short reedy battery in here, the shorty battery. Tell us why you're choosing the shorty pack. I know sometimes you switch around, but you probably more than anybody run the shorty pack. And what have you found with this and the weight of the car that's making a difference?
When the shorty pack came out, the low C guys were running it a lot, and so I basically found a setup that worked with it, and the car just has a ton more corner speed just because the car is lighter. A few little setup changes made it work, and since then I've been running it pretty much everywhere.
Okay, with the that's with the light reedy battery, and do you think that it's was an advantage when you're racing at Hot Rod earlier this year? That's outdoors. We're talking about indoors, but Dustin tells us he runs the small battery indoors, and you're kind of running it everywhere. You're running a substantially lighter car than most, I guess, guys on the team. You think that's that's helping you out quite a bit?
Yeah, I think even outdoors, the main thing is just whether the traction is up or not. I think the more the traction, the you know, the lighter the car, the faster it's going to be.
Okay. You're running the LRP motors. Are you running the 8.5?
Yep.
8.5 LRP motor. What do you do when you're on a track this size? I know it's small and tight. We talked about it in the pits quite a bit. Do you change how much power you use depending on the track or the traction? And how do you adjust for the, you know, the different conditions indoors?
Basically, I've been running the same, you know, power for a while. You know, the LRP motors, I run an 8.5 with a smaller rotor. I run the 12.0 rotor. You know, the same speedo settings pretty much the whole time. I might go down in gearing depending on, you know, the size of the track, but pretty standard stuff.
When you go down in gearing on a track like this, what do you typically feel on the track? I mean, I know guys talk about this stuff all the time, but as an advantage, one tooth on the pinion, what do you feel on the straightaway or in the small short shoots?
Yeah, I mean, you know, one tooth on the pinion can be a lot on, you know, a smaller track. Basically, going down in a pinion just gives it less overall power, top power and, you know, bottom power.
Okay, let's, you know, we kind of moved on. We're on your, you know, your shock program. We talked about the tires and the power. And we're talking about the wing here a little bit, you know, the body and the wing combination. This is something that we released at the Finland Worlds. And we had the plus 8 finisher body and the high clearance wing. You've been running this for a little while. Tell us, you know, why you choose this style. You know, we have a couple different ones, and what's it doing for you, especially when you're racing indoors? That's what we're doing this weekend.
Yeah, I mean, the finisher body, once it came out, you know, I instantly liked it, especially in the Worlds. It seemed to, you know, jump straighter over the big jumps. Just a good overall body for traction, steering. And the wing, you know, the high clearance wing, is just really stable and, you know, has plenty of steering and traction.
Well, Steven's got a ton of experience on the indoor tracks. He's pretty much an expert at the indoor National Series events this year. He's has quite a few wins under his belt. He's got the Team Associate car, the B4.1 WC. Steven, thanks for giving us a little kind of inside scoop here, giving us a pro pit tip here. And we thank everybody for watching. We're here with Red RC.